Alrighty guys, this is me, the Almighty D, Aragon from YouTube. Today we're unboxing the iPhone 15 Pro Max Ultra Hybrid Case by Spigen. However, this is the natural titanium MagFit case. I've never had a Ultra Hybrid that was not clear, so I'm very curious how this looks and how this blends with the natural titanium that will then also match my Apple Watch Ultra and my also iPhone 15 Pro Max natural titanium. So let me just get to unboxing it. Spigen always comes with pretty minimalistic packaging. They don't waste too much money on it. 100% recycled paper, it says on the box, in case you guys are just curious about it. And it just flops out, and that's kind of what you get. You get that, and that's it, right? On the back of the box, nothing too spiffy. Honestly, it's just a slim case by them. The Ultra Hybrids are usually pretty protective, very sparse. I believe they have a pretty good drop-proof rating. I'll put that on the video right in front of us. Right now, I'm using the Banks case. This has been my most used one. As you see, it's a very fingerprint magnet, or if you have greasy hands, it's not the best. So, we're just going to take this thing. I'm doing this all one-handed because my arm is still messed up. You see right here, I've been wearing a splint for a few months, so a lot of my content is done one-armed, sadly. But inside the case, they have a protector that you peel, and then you put your phone in. Honestly, I already don't see it matching too much, but it is pretty nice. So I'll just go off. We'll look at the case before we peel off anything. We'll look at the air cushion design that you'll see right here. Pretty good space. The buttons look pretty nice. Has little air bubble pockets in the corner. You see that in the back right corner right there. Going around the case, it has a lanyard slot. I didn't expect to see that. Cutouts look pretty good. We'll see how they line up when you put it in. Again, air bubble, very slim case. Wonder how strong the magnet is. This is the natural titanium matching one. I'm pretty sure a white one would probably look better. This looks kind of off-white slash gray, but we'll see how it performs. On the back, you can see the camera lip is pretty good. Very nice, very lightweight case, honestly. Very, very lightweight. Like, if I was to compare this to my Banks one, let's see. Sorry, guys, I have to put this on my lap, so drop my phone and break my screen protector, because that happens to me quite a bit, depending on how you take it off. And yeah, it just flew out of my hand. So honestly, I think the Banks one might be lighter. They're about the same weight. I really need to invest in a scale. Guys, do you want to see a scale? I don't know. This again, this is the natural titanium phone that we're going to put on. So we're going to put it on this bad boy. Honestly, maybe the closer I look at it, it might match a little bit better. I haven't even put it in yet, but I do foresee it matching very nicely. But we're going to put it on the back of this case real quick. We're going to peel off the inside of it one-handed. I know, guys, I'm sorry. I don't know how crystal clear it is, so you always kind of just put the case in. At least this is how I do it. I always put a camera in first, and then I put it on. Now, I think I have a notification that came in, so I got to hide that real quick. We're going to just see how this aligns in and see how lightweight this case feels. Oh, it's just a Pokemon Go notification. Again, it goes around the base of it. I cleared the actual protector. I see the glare in the background from the sticky. I didn't peel off the back sticky yet. At least I don't think I did. Actually, I did. In the case, looks pretty nice. Honestly, feels really lightweight. I don't know if this case is lighter. Now, again, the off-whiteness. I don't know how something just flew across the room, guys. Sorry, I thought there was a ghost in this room. The off-whiteness does match it. I feel like an actual white would probably look better, but this probably won't get as dirty. So, racing here, there's no boundaries. Nothing pushes it. Again, the camera, you know, the camera always, when you have a case that doesn't have, like, pockets in the corner to raise it up slightly, it will always kind of tilt semi. So, we're going to look at the base of it. We have Pokemon Go open just because. The buttons, are they responsive? Let's see. Let's take a look at it real quick. Pretty responsive. Action button's responsive. If they don't have a button on the action button, what are you guys doing wrong? Camera lip. Let's take a look at that lip right there. Camera lip's just very good. Let's get a closer look at it. Camera lip, definitely protected there. Very clean, very nice. Has these little corner lifts. Don't understand why. I guess because the back plastic, but again, if you wear keys or anything, you're probably gonna scratch it anyway. What's the lip look like with a screen protector? Lip with the screen protector, Fairly good lip. I have a screen protector on, so the fact that it has a lip on top of the screen protector, very good for a slim case. Has the lanyard loop. We're not going to use that, but I do like the lanyard loops. And then we're going to take a look at the cutouts. As you see, they're crisscrossing right into it. Very, very methodical how it's measured. Pretty much perfect. Damn near perfect. You could fit a fat, chunky USB-C cable in it. Power button as well. Just as responsive. Overall, not too much branding. The only branding you'll see right here, as you'll see, is right on the spine. Not too bad at all, honestly. And, you know, obviously they got to put their branding on it. So, let's see how strong the magnet is. Alrighty, guys, let's see how good the magnet is. Wow, my wallet is looking dingy. It hasn't been used in a while. Magnet, actually really secure. Lift it off of it. Very secure. Remember this thing? The best SSD holder that I got for 10 bucks. Well, I still have it. I'm not going to get rid of it. Why would I? Wow, this one's really stuck. Jesus. Okay, that one's really good. Now, let's try a MagSafe charger right here. Whoa. Again, really good magnet. Really, really good magnet. Like, I'm struggling to get it off. Wow. That is actually a really good magnet, as you see. So, definitely has a great magnet. Definitely blends well with the natural titanium. I feel like they could have went with a different color, like very slightly different, and it would have probably looked a little bit better. Kind of like my Case Coup one, but honestly, the off-white doesn't look too bad. Feels very simple. Probably going to use this the next week and see how I like it. Overall, so far, I'm really enjoying it. You know, feels really good in the hand. In the speaking cases, you can never go wrong. I do wish they had the smoky black crystal, liquid crystal one that they used to have back in the day. With MagSafe infused, but I guess because the liquid crystal is so lightweight, they just can't do it with MagSafe. I don't know. I definitely would like to see that from them. But anyway, guys, this is me, the Almighty D, Daragon from YouTube. This is the Natural Titanium iPhone 15 Pro Max Ultra Hybrid Clear Case. Let me know what you think down below. Hopefully this video helps you out, because I could not find a video on this one, and I just wanted to get it covered for everybody on my channel. Anyway, guys, it's been a while since I covered any content. I've just been busy and kind of just been trying to worry about my health more so than anything. But anyway, guys, comment, like, subscribe, use my affiliate links. It's me, the Almighty D, Daragon from YouTube. Deuces.